Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we have a new launch from Nykaa, that is e.l.f. Cosmetics. So e.l.f. is finally on Nykaa. I think I'll be posting this the day it's launching or like a day before, something like that. But this is not a sponsored video. I just got the PR and I thought I'll try the products out because e.l.f. is really hyped in the States. It's a very affordable prices. So I don't really have the prices of these products yet. They did not even drop my brushes. That's it. Usually they send the prices over the email, but they didn't send the prices, and the package doesn't have the price on it either because they're like not for sale and they're PR packages. I'm sure it'll be affordable. I'm guessing most of the products will be below like $1,000 or $700 to $800 because e.l.f. is really affordable. Like, our Miss Claire is their e.l.f. You know, if that makes sense. So I'm excited to try the products. So let's get started. So the first product we have is their famous primer. This is their e.l.f. Poreless Puffy Putty Primer. So this one has been so hyped because it's like, you know, a dupe for the Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer or something like that. And they said this is a dupe and, you know, it was like really viral for some time, like I think a year back. But I never got to try it. So this is the first time I'm going to try it. Now, I'm not really a big like primer person. I don't know why. It kind of feels like it clogs my pores. So it just made my hair sometimes, so I kind of stay away, and my makeup does like go on well even without primers. But we are going to try this one because it's kafi zyada famous. To actually know how it performs, I'm just going to apply this on one side of my face, and I'm like just going to apply foundation on the other one without any primer so that I can see if there's any difference, you know, if for the primer, because if I'm applying both the sides then I won't understand, because even without using a primer I don't usually have like any issues as such. So I'm just going to take this, I'm going to just use my hands, and I'm just going to you know, it's very like thick and silky. Sorry, I was about to apply on both the sides. I'm just going to take that and apply this on just my right side, so right side of my nose and right side of my face. Just going to apply this here. Moving on to foundation. Now they didn't send any foundation or concealer. I'm hoping, I really hope they would send me the e.l.f. camouflage concealer. I guess I do have the concealer, but the shade I have is so damn light. Like, I estimated it wrong, so the one I have is like 7 medium or something, and it's way too light on me. So I thought, you know, I hopefully they'll send the better shade and I actually can test and understand if it really works, because I usually mix it with something else and it kind of performs like the PAC Spotlight concealer. It is like, you know, very full coverage, very matte, and does not budge, like, you know, that type of concealer. So anyway, they don't have foundation concealer, so I'm just going to use mine, but I'm going to try the sponge out. So they send this camo concealer sponge. Now they didn't send me concealer, but they did send me the sponge, that's what I'm saying. So let's see the before and after of the sponge. This is before wetting it, please ignore my nails. So this is after wetting the sponge, and it is a very like nice and soft sponge. So I'm just going to use my foundation. I'm mixing my NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop and the Maybelline foundation. So the sponge is beautiful. The product is going on really well. It's a very soft sponge. This reminds me of the Vichy sponge, but Vichy one is even more softer, and it's a lot bigger than this. It's like an oval. It's a very, very weird shape for a sponge. So, but you know, the product is going on really well. Everything looks really nice. Now if I compare the sides for the primer, so this side is the side I applied the primer and this side I did not. So if I see like very, very zoomed in and very up close, then there is a very minute difference. So you know, left side where I have like itty bitty tiny pores, I don't see it on the right side at all, but the left side I can see like very, very tiny. But that's what I'm saying, like usually I don't go in with primer, like from this distance I would not be able to tell, but from this distance I can tell that there is a tiny difference. So if you are somebody who does have large pores, then I think it does fill the job, like, you know, fill the pores and like, you know, gives a very nice finish. It is not weird at all. It did fill the pores really well and it's giving a very nice finish to the skin. So anyways, I'm just going to like later put concealer powder etc, and then actually decide in the end like how everything goes well or not. So next for concealer, I have the e.l.f. 16-hour camo concealer. Now I bought this before lockdown, so I hope it's not like expired. There's no expiry date on this, but there's no expiry date on this, but the shade is super light. This is the shade medium sand. Like once I apply, you'll see how light it is. So I'm just going to add like actually one dot, and I'm going to go in with my concealer, which can kind of balance this out. So I'm going to go in with the Benefit. So I actually wanted to wait and like buy the base products also and then do like an entire review, but again I thought, you know, I can do a second part. See, you can see the difference between the concealer I use and that concealer, right? So it kind of way too light on me. Let me know if you want to see like a foundation, concealer and more products than what I'm using. Later I can buy and do that. Like if there are other products which I've not tried, if you want me to know and they do have like more base options, then I would definitely like to do a review again. Let me know if you want me to. See, that little bit of dot of like that white concealer only kind of made my under eye really bright, but it is a very good concealer. I just wish I can actually try it on its own without using like, you know, other concealer, so that I know the finish and how it performs or stays, etc. So next we have this monochromatic multi-stick. It's a very shimmery type of cream product. I'm not going to apply this on my cheeks. I just try to apply it a little on the high points of my face and see how it looks, because I don't want, like, you know, it to exaggerate my texture or anything. There's very shimmery particles in this product. Let me try this with a brush. Yeah, I'm not going to apply this more. It is performing like how I thought it would. It is that very like, it's one of the products I don't really like. It is good for the high points of my face. It is good if you have really like beautiful skin. But even if you have beautiful skin, it kind of is the lifting off my foundation a little bit. So I don't really like it. You can see this kind of got a little patchy because the product kind of lifted off my foundation from that point. So that is something obviously nobody likes. You did so much work on the base. So maybe you can just use this if you don't wear any makeup, or you just use a BB cream, then you can use it. But other than that, it is not good. All right, Face is set. They actually didn't send me a lot of base products, and so I'm like very curious if they do have a lot of base products or no. I'm sure they do. I think they just didn't feel like sending it to me. They sent me a lot of eye products though. So anyways, I just ordered. I just added a little bit of bronzer and a little bit of blush. Details will be in the description box. Now they did send me highlighter. So they sent me the metallic flare highlighter. The shade looks very beautiful. So I'm really excited. If it can only open. It is not opening. So this is the shade 24K Gold. It is a very... I was so excited to dip in and literally nothing came on my hand. Yeah, I'm so... Okay, I mean, it doesn't matter how it's on the hand as far as it performs good on the face. Just using the regular brush I use, I'm just taking that properly. Nothing. Why the hell is this so dry? Should I just scrape off a little bit? Just scraped off a little bit. Now let's see. Yeah, now it's better. Probably the top layer was like too dry or something. But even then, it's not giving. It's not like very like luminous, creamy type of feel. It is a little bit dry. Up close, the highlighter does look good, but it doesn't look great. That's what I'm saying. So for brows, they sent me this Insta Lift brow pencil. So this is the Insta Brow Lift in the shade Deep Brown. And I'm just going to brush my brows and let's see how this goes. So this is how the tip of the brow like looks. So I'm not sure, like it is very sharp for now, but like later I don't know how sharp it's gonna be like once I start using it. Let's see. So they said deep brown, but kind of is a gray black. So I don't know, like, you know, I expected it to be brown. I mean, this is the shade I actually go for, so I'm really great. But I thought, you know, they said deep brown and it would not look that great. But for somebody who wants to buy deep brown and gets this, they would be disappointed. It doesn't say on the pencil the color, but you know, on the packaging, it does say it is deep brown. So that's the reason I'm assuming it's deep brown. Pencil is actually quite good. It's going on well. It is properly pigmented, not too much, not too less. And the tip is also really nice and thin. Now that is good, bro. Next we have a Wow Brow. This is their Voluminizing Fiber Gel. This is the shade Brunette. So I'm just going to... So now see, this is the shade dark or deep brown or more brown, and this is like gray black. So, but this says brunette, so I understand if they call it brunette because want it to be lighter, but this one I don't know why they call it to be like deep brown. For my brow hair, the shade is too light because it does like my, I have jet black brows, so you know, this is a little lighter for my brow. I'm sure they have like, you know, gray black or something like that. Just going to see the performance of how this is going to be. So for next for eyeshadow palette, we have this cute little eyeshadow palette. This is called the Cream and Sugar Eyeshadow Palette. It has like that browns and warm tones. I'll die by the time I remove all these stickers only. It's not opening. I hate these stickers. Oh my god. Finally, that took an hour to get out. My nail broke, everything happened, but it's finally out. So first I'm going to take this shade. They don't even have any like name for the shade on the palette, so I'm just going to take this. I'm just going to probably just like set my concealer which I put on the eyelid, because this shade is like not deep enough for me for like a transition shade. I just have like one shade which I can actually use in the crease. So now I'm going to take this brown shade and I'm going to just add it on the outer corner and deepen it, because a very like dark brown, it's going to be intense. Yeah, I knew that it's going to be too strong, and so I'm just going to add that right here and I'm going to blend out the edges. Now I'm going to go in back with that lighter shade and I'm going to blend out the brown even further. So the shadow did blend quite decently. There is nothing, you know, patchy much. It did take a little time to blend and the color is really pigmented. You saw like the brown was quite pigmented, so I don't have any complaint about pigmentation. Next I'm going in with this shade and I'm going to just like take my finger, and that is like really really beautiful, very pigmented and very nice. But the color is a little lighter than what I expected it to be. Like in the pan you can see it looks like a very champagne-y gold type of thing, but on my eye it looks a very like icy a gold. So I'm just going to, what I do is I'm just going to take this shade which is more like bronzy. I'm just going to pop that on that so that it kind of gets balanced. So that is the eye look we got. I couldn't do anything babahoom obviously, because there's literally four shades in this cute palette and like I don't have, like they didn't send me more options. So for liner, I'm going in with their e.l.f. Precision Liquid Liner. Now what I always do is when I get a liner, I see if it actually bleeds. If it bleeds, then I don't like really have a big like liking for it. So let's see how it does. So okay, there is no bleeding, that is amazing. So let's like go and apply. It is a very nice and precise applicator, so I hope it does like give that type of application. Okay, Anyway, that went on well. The liner was quite easy to use. The you know, applicator is quite stable. It's not very flimsy and not get like does not flare up everywhere. You can see I got a very cute wing, also not cute, it's actually quite long. And let's see now how this side goes. Left side is always the most difficult to apply. Right, my wings can never be equal because my eyes are only so different. They kind of look fine. Can maybe make it this one a little fatter, but it will look too. So the liner is pretty decent. It went on easily. One swipe application, like you don't really need to go on twice. But the thing is, if you do go on like more than two times on the same place, and if it's still wet, then it kind of removes the product from that particular point and moves it away. But like one application, then you know it comes like this smooth. It did dry down. It is you know, a semi matte finish, not like that super matte one. Actually, still drying down. I kind of feel like it's a little wet. It looks a little bit, you know, shiny, not too much, but it's definitely not like a matte black eyeliner. So next, moving on to this e.l.f. Length and Volume Mascara. My wing is so cute today. I'm so happy. So the wand is kafi small. I'm used to very big wands. That sounded so bad. But small wand, and let's see how that actually applies. The product is actually not even like, you know, there. Literally everything of mascara is in the wand, and this wand is shaped so weirdly that I feel like the product is not even, you know, there in the wand, and it's not transferring onto my lashes that much. The mascara is good. It is not like, again, really great, not something very sensational. It is a very like decent mascara. One thing is, it does like curl up the lash like very well, and it just like holds it up in place. That's something I really nice. But in terms of length, there is nothing. It gives volume, but there is no length. Like it says, it is just a little bit voluminous. It's not like my L'Oreal Lash Paradise or Maybelline Colossal, which I really like. This is a very like basic, you know, mascara. I mean, we are in 2020. Makeup game has stepped up so much. I mean, I would go for this mascara if I'm going for a very natural look and I don't want my mascaras to look very like strong, then I would go for this one. But if it's like very cheap, the thing is, I'm very like annoyed because I don't know the price points, because I can judge the product according to the price. But like, let's say this mascara is 200 or 300, then I'd be like, go for it, because a decent mascara for 200-300 bucks. But if it's like 700-800, then it is not, you know, good one according to that. So next up, I have this liquid glitter eyeshadow, which I forgot to use. I'm just going to try to pop this on my existing eyeshadow, and let's see how it looks. It's very green and like, you know, that army green and glittery, but I don't like it for this look. So I'm going to go in back with the eyeshadow, and I'm just going to pop that on and hope it's looking going to look good, because at this point I've added so much of it. It's ridiculous. So finally, we just have lips left, and for lips I have two things. One is their liquid matte lipstick, and one is the lip plumping gloss. So in this, they gave me Mauvelicious. I don't know why they felt like sending me such random things. This is a very pinky shade. I'm very bronze and very like orange and very warm. This would look so like offbeat, but you know what, let's do it. But before that, I'm just going to go in with my lip liner. This is the Lenfor Beauty lip liner in the shade the deep brown. No, sorry, dusky brown. So I'm going to pop this shade Mauvelicious. I don't know how to pronounce it. See, I told you, it looks so bad with this entire look. I just wish they sent me like a brown lipstick. Next, they've sent me a gloss, so hopefully this gloss will help it. This is the Champagne Glam, so it looks a little like warm type of gloss, so hopefully it has color. And yeah, that's it. Oh my god, this is tingling on my lips, you guys. This is very tingling. I think the gloss, like it's a lip plump, like I think it's legit like something lip plumping type of gloss because I can feel something tingling my lip. What is there in this? Lips are tingling. It's not hurting or anything like that. It's just a weird tingling sensation which I have on my lip. So yeah guys, that's it for this look. The tingling sensation on my lips is so nice and weird at the same time. I did forget to mention that e.l.f. is 100% vegan and a cruelty-free brand. So let's quickly go through the products and I'll give you my final thoughts about them. So the first one we used was this. e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. Now I think if you do have like really large pores and you do see a really big difference whenever you use a primer, then I think you can definitely go with this one. It did not make my makeup weird. It did fill in like the tiny pores which I have. It did fill in that also and it gave me like a really good finish. So if you're somebody who really likes to use a primer and you have really large pores, then I think you can definitely try this one. I hope this is below 500 or 600. The next one we used is this sponge. Now I really liked this sponge. I enjoyed it. I liked it for powder. The Weird Cheap actually made it really go into places and blend out really well. So I really like this sponge. So if this is less than like 300 or 400, then definitely grab this one because it's a very good sponge. It did blend my makeup very well. You can see everything looks very flawless and I really like this sponge. Then the next one we used is this e.l.f. highlighter. Now initially when I used it, it was not nice, but after I scraped it off a little bit and applied it, it did give like a good effect. It's not the best highlighter in the market. It is good but not really great. So do grab this if it's less than like 300 or 400, because more than 500 you have beautiful highlighters already. The Nykaa one is really nice, the Maybelline one is really nice. So if it's more than 500, then I don't think it is worth it. But if it's less than 300 or 400, then I think you can give this a try, because I mean in the lesser options there's only Wet n Wild, which is like cheaper than 400, which is good. But other than that, I personally have not tried something which is little good. But if in that range you're looking for one, I think then you can give this one a try. So the next one you use is this Insta Lift Brow Pencil. They said the shade is a deep brown, but it's more like gray black according to me, and it did well. My brows look really nice. The point was very precise. They did get filled in really well. It's not too pigmented or not too less pigmented, and it did good job. So again, the depends on the price point. If it's less than 500 400, then you can definitely grab this one, because I've just tried a couple of other things which are really good under 500. But if this less than like 400 or 500, then you can give this a try. I'm so sorry, I'm really really sorry that I don't know the price points and I'm not able to give like a thorough review. I don't know how I can know before the launch, but I wanted to put this video up so that you can actually know the product, because anyways you can see the price point accordingly on the Nykaa website. That's why I'm kind of giving you the comparison that if it is less than 500, then it is good. If it's more, it is a good product. I'm just like judging it on the base of the price point, because there are better products. Like if you go on a higher range, there are like same similar products which you might already be using, so you don't have to like have like this one, like you need to have it, nothing like that. It is a decent brow pencil for sure. I would definitely reach for it very often if you know I want to use like for a very regular makeup look. I think I would definitely try this one. Then the next one is this eyeshadow palette. It's the itty bitty tiny eyeshadow palette. So I'm assuming there are different type of shades. So this is the brown one. I'm sure there's a pink one, there's an orange one, there's a more mauvey one. So different types of itty bitty palettes. So again, if this one is like less than 300 or like 350, 200, like something like that, then you can grab these. They're very tiny palettes, so they're very travel friendly. You can just like pop on 2-3 in your bag and you can do various different looks. But if it's more than 300, then I don't think it's worth it, because you just get 4 shades. You get Nykaa Kit palettes which are like 9 shades for 300 or 400, and they perform really well. You have like transition shade, crease shade, deeper shade, metallic shade, everything in that. But you know, if you're looking for something, if this is more cheaper than that and you have some colors you really like, then you can grab like a couple of them and then you can put it in your bag and you can use anytime you want. The quality is really nice. You can see on my eyes, it does look good. Now if I have to judge this on its own without comparing it to other products, I know I'm comparing, it can be a little annoying because I'm not really telling if this is nice. This is definitely nice, but my approach to makeup, or generally when I give people advice, is that if there's something better in the same price point, then go for that. And then you can this is like a luxury which you can add on later, because you don't need so much wastage, so much product for just like using once a while, or if you're just like normal person who uses like once in 1 week or 2 weeks, then you don't need so many things and create so much waste for no reason at all. But on its own, it is a good one. It is really good palette, so you can try this one. Then the next one is the eyeliner. Now the eyeliner went on really beautifully. My wing looks perfect. It was kind of very easy to use. It dried down very well. It is not moving until now. I have to see. I will do a check-in in like a couple of hours and see if it's budging. Mascara. Now the mascara is like a 7 out of 10 for me. Again, like if it's 200, 300 or 400, then this is really nice. But if it's more like 500 or 600, then you have the Maybelline Colossal, which is really nice. A little more up, you have 700 or 800 ke liye. You have Lash Paradise, which is more nice. And even 500 days, there's so many different mascaras, like the Essence one, the Maybelline one, which perform a lot better, give really voluminous and lengthening lashes. This one is not so great. It did like an okay job of like a very basic concealer, like a mascara back in 2016 or 17 type of a mascara, not like wow type of lashes. So I would not really recommend that one. The next one is this Monochromatic Stick. Like, I think you already know where I stand on this. I don't really like it that much. It's a really prefer, like, you know, it's a personal choice of how people like a product. I'm not a person who likes like shimmery products on my cheeks. It doesn't like just look good on my cheeks. It looks very weird. It adds a lot of texture, and this one particular was lifting off my foundation a little bit. So if I want to use it and add just like a fluff of color and have a little bit of shine on my cheeks generally without wearing makeup, then I would definitely use this one. But on top of makeup, I would not use, because it'll exaggerate the texture and it'll remove the product. So I not so much. Then finally, the lip products. Now both of the lip products wore really well. Like, it's just a lipstick, what you know can be there. The shade Marvelous is really beautiful. Actually, this is one of the shades I would go for like on an everyday basis. But this particular look, it is not looking that great, because it's more that pinky tone type of this, and I would prefer something which is more warm and brown. But judging on the base's formulation, it is quite comfortable on the lips. It went on really well. It was not that patchy. Now the gloss, though, it was tingling for until one point, but now it stopped. I don't know if my lips are more plumper than before. I don't know, you guys, I can't see it. You should only go back in the footage, check how my lips were before and see, like, you know, if they're a little more plumper. The tingling sensation was gone and the gloss looks really, really nice. I really like this gloss. Actually, it's such a good one. It is not too sticky. I hate glosses when they're like extremely sticky. It's very comfortable, went on very well. It's just giving me that glossy effect. It's a little shimmery, it's giving me that shine as well, and really comfortable. I just had that tingling sensation got to me a little bit, but now that's gone, so it's kind of comfortable to wear.
Hi guys, so it's almost 10:30. That means it's been 7 hours that I put my makeup on, ignore the clothes in the background, and this is how it looks. The eyeliner did not budge, the eyeshadow did not budge. My base looks really nice, my brows look really nice. So yay for that. There is no texture, no pores, etc. exaggerated on the, you know, primer side. And yeah, I just add a little bit of other, like, you know, lipstick, because I was shooting something else. But other than that, it did hold on pretty well. The highlighter also looks really nice. Where is the highlighter? See? Yeah, that is my check-in for this video.
So yeah guys, that is my quick and mini, I don't think it's a mini review because I don't know the timestamp of the video yet, but yeah, that was my review on few of the products of e.l.f. If you do want me to try more products, then leave the product names in the description and what products you want to try me, like make me want you for what products you want me to try, so that I can you know, try, buy and try them for you. And yeah, that's it for this video. I hope this video helped you decide what products you need to get and what you don't have to get. I mean, at the end of the day, it's just your choice. Everything will be in the description. So if you do end up buying something, do use my links. I'll get a little bit of commission. Make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in my next video.